been alive for 4.5 centuries. I am immortal.
I thought I'd share with you some recent vintage card pickups and just a couple hobby thoughts real quick. All right, let's get into the pickups. So first one, 1955 Bowman Willie Mays. So love the set, love Willie, arguably the greatest player of all time. Here's the back for you. Just turned 91 years old, so there is his 1973 Tops. That's his bookend card. His last card, New York Mets. So the condition on that was excellent. Happy to add that to the collection. And keeping on with the Willie Mays train, 1960. Not one of my favorite sets, but relatively affordable Mays. So I like to add as many as I can. And that's the white back. 1956 Topps Willie Mays, so great action photo, probably my favorite set ever. And this one is just super cool. All the comic images on the back really just screams, you know, history and vintage. And you saw on the back there is the 1960 Carl Yastrzemski rookie. These often have the surface imperfection, so it's pretty normal on the centering issues. This guy won a triple crown, over 3,500 career hits. And that is a gray back of the 60, Yastrzemski. And here is a 1968 Johnny Bench. So the greatest catcher that's ever lived. Just an incredible player. Didn't have the longevity kind of like Molina or, you know, Yachty, but he did it on both sides of the ball. And he did it for championship teams. So there's the 68 bench. And just a few thoughts on some recent hobby news. You know, just some videos I've been watching. There's a lot of people that talk about, you know, certain things, certain cards, what you should buy. And a lot of those people have been in the hobby for, you know, a couple years, a few years. They really don't have a good understanding of the hobby and, you know, how things work. And I see them pump certain cards, dump cards, focus on, you know, what you enjoy. But make sure that you do a lot of your own research. Keep in mind that these people that do a lot of these videos are, you know, they're just in it to flip cards. So a lot of them aren't even really collectors. You know, they'll get into a card and, you know, they'll be back out of it. Build up a collection that you can enjoy, you know, in 20 years from now that might even have a little value. If you focus on, you know, the greats of the game, the history, you're not at as much risk as, you know, if you're focusing on modern, ultra-modern cards. So just keep that in mind. I mean, focus on what you want to focus on, but, you know, make sure that you're doing it right. You're not overpaying. Be patient and, you know, enjoy what you're doing. It's not a rat race. You know, you don't have to hustle and bustle and, you know, flip and pump and, you know, buy all the time. But, you know, it's nice to be able to key in on certain cards and players that you enjoy collecting and, you know, just be patient, you know, looking for that deal or, you know, looking for a card and, you know, the condition or whatever, you know, your criteria is for your collection. So I'll be sending some of these cards off for grading. Some might not be for grading, but, you know, I like to build up Hall of Fame registry of rookie cards. And, you know, I like to collect the greatest that have ever played. So however you do it, I mean, just, you know, enjoy it, be patient, and always be learning. So, you know, I've been in the hobby for 30 years and I don't know everything, and I never will. I mean, most people, you know, now they think they can get into the hobby and after a year or two they really know everything, but that's just not the case, and you can't predict markets. And, you know, so I try to focus my collection on on Hall of Fame vintage. And if you can, I mean, make money in the hobby, certainly. Obviously, it's much harder now than it has been in the years with the prices of wax being what they are. But I really don't rip a lot of wax, but here and there, I still like to do it just for fun. But there's so many parts of the hobby that are enjoyable to me. So, thanks for tuning in, guys. Take care. I'll have some more videos coming up, and take it easy.